Hi everyone, I'm Gerga Basic. I'm Senior Research Associate at University of Chicago's Urban Theory Lab, and I'm joined here by my colleague, architect and sound designer, Adam Fosberg. Today we're gonna show you a video called Backfire, The Age of Megafires, which is a 12-minute geospatial documentary that was commissioned by the Fondation Cartier for the exhibition called Trees. It's currently on display at the Power Station of Art in Shanghai. And so the concept for the piece was developed by the anthropologist Bruce Albert, geographer Françoise-Michel Letourneau, and myself. And Adam was a sound designer for the piece, and he worked with me on the video editing and motion graphics. So the main narrative line of the video is that fire is an ancient human tool, but as climate change accelerates, it's now an existential planetary threat. So we've entered the era of megafires in which fire as a tool is backfiring. At the core of the piece is a display of cumulative surface areas destroyed by megafires in 8 regions of the world. So we're showcasing the tally of burnt areas from year 2000 to 2020 in China, Siberia, the DRC, Brazil, Australia, California, Portugal, and Indonesia. And each of these locations also serve as a narrative lens, exemplifying one particular aspect or one category of the megafires phenomenon. Besides showcasing the areas affected by fires, these thematic close-up views also reveal cumulative forest loss, greenhouse gas emission estimates, and they conclude with a zoom out showing smoke plume animation that then also serve as a transition into the next location. In terms of videography, the piece is conceived as an immersive one-shot circumnavigation of the Earth, zooming in and out of these 8 regions. And this concept allowed us to develop a choreographed cartographic narrative that moves between scales and between continents to illustrate the devastating effects of wildfires worldwide.
And before we get to the video, I'll just make a couple notes about the sounds. So the sound design followed from the cadence of the videography. The predictable rhythm was also a nice opportunity to make the sounds a bit more musical and not overtly ambient, which kind of differentiated the two scales. So the sound of the continental scale is a kind of spacey and vast. Here I was thinking specifically just about remote sensing and how we might imagine that it sounds, droning and humming. And at the site scale, it's all kind of about sonifying the data. The volume of the pulse corresponds with the burnt area for each year in our data set, giving a sense of scale within each site. And without further ado, here's the video.